The air around us contains a variety of particles, including dust, pollen, and pollutants. When these particles enter our respiratory system, they can cause significant health issues. However, before they reach our lungs, they must navigate a series of anatomical defenses that have evolved to protect us. These particles face three major challenges on their way to the deepest parts of the lungs. First, they encounter the nasal vestibule, which is lined with coarse hairs that act as a primary filter, trapping larger particles such as sand or large pollen grains. However, some smaller particles can bypass this initial defense. Next, the particles enter the nasal cavity where they encounter the nasal conchae or turbinates. These bony structures create turbulence in the airflow, causing mid-sized particles to collide with the mucus-covered walls and get trapped. This process, known as impaction, ensures that many of these particles are removed before they can proceed further into the respiratory system. However, smaller particles can still navigate through this turbulent region. The final challenge lies in the bronchial tree, a network of branching airways that become progressively narrower as they extend deeper into the lungs. In these bronchi and bronchioles, super small particles, which are light enough to be influenced by Brownian motion, often collide with the mucus lining the airway walls and become trapped. Only particles of an optimal size can avoid being trapped and make it all the way to the alveoli, the tiny air sacs where gas exchange occurs. This complex filtration system ensures that only a few particles ever reach the alveoli and enter the bloodstream, where they can cause significant health problems. Historically, this system effectively filtered out most airborne substances, such as dust and smoke. However, modern activities like driving cars, burning fossil fuels, and indoor cooking have increased the number of particles in the air. This influx of particles poses two significant problems. First, the increased particle load can overwhelm the respiratory system's defenses, reducing their effectiveness. Second, many modern airborne particles are of a problematic size, small enough to bypass the nasal vestibule and nasal conchae, but large enough to avoid being trapped in the bronchi and bronchioles. These particles reach the alveoli, cross into the bloodstream, and travel to various organs, potentially causing severe health issues such as cancer, cardiovascular diseases, and strokes. Fortunately, our advanced brains can help us address this challenge. Despite being responsible for much of the pollution, we can also develop strategies to manage airborne particles. We can monitor air quality to avoid heavily polluted areas and times, preventing the respiratory system from becoming overwhelmed. Additionally, we can use air purifiers in our homes and offices and wear masks to add extra layers of filtration. Ultimately, the best solution is to reduce the production of harmful particles in the first place. After all, protecting our respiratory health is a matter of life and death. If you want to support the channel, please like and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it. And there should be some other helpful videos popping up on your screen right about now that I think you will enjoy. And just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. Thank you so much for watching. Have a blessed day, and as always, breathe easy, my friend.